गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, विल स्टार्ट विद इंग्लिश रीडर। विल स्टार्ट विद द पोयम द डक एंड द कंगारू। सो इन दिस पोयम द डक वॉन्ट्स टू सी द वर्ल्ड बियॉन्ड ऑफ हिज पॉन्ड एंड सो ही रिक्वेस्ट हिज फ्रेंड कंगारू टू गिव हिम अ राइड। डज द कंगारू एग्री? सो रीड ऑन टू फाइंड आउट। सेड द डक टू द कंगारू, Good gracious, how you hop over the field and water too, as if you never would stop. My life is a bore in this nesting pond, and I long to go out in the world beyond. I wish I could hop like you, said the duck to the kangaroo. So in this stanza, the duck said to the kangaroo, the duck exclaims to the kangaroo that it is very impressed with the kangaroo ability to hop over land and water seemingly without the needs to stop. The duck explains that its own life is pond is boring and that it wants to explore the world. It would fulfill its dream. It would hop like the kangaroo. So, please give me a ride on your back, said the duck to the kangaroo. I would sit quite still and say nothing but quack the whole of the long day through, and we had go to D and the jelly bow leap over the land and over the sea. Please take me a ride, oh do, said the duck to the kangaroo. So in this stanza, the duck asks the kangaroo for a ride on the kangaroo's back. The duck promises it would sit still and only quack all day. The duck purposes traveling to place like the sea and the jelly bowl lee, crossing land and water in the process. The duck repeats its polite plea for a ride on the kangaroo's back. Said the kangaroo to the duck, this is require a little reflection. Perhaps on the whole it might bring me luck, and there seems but one objection, which is, if you will let me speak so bold, your feet are unpleasantly wet and cold, and would probably give me the rheumatism, said the kangaroo. So in this stanza, the kangaroo explains to the duck that it will need to consider the duck's proposal. Why? It might be a source of good luck for the kangaroo. The kangaroo does have just one concern, to speak plainly. The duck's wet, cold feet might give the kangaroo's rheumatism. It is a kind of disease, joint inflammation, if they are on the kangaroo's back. Said the duck, as I sat on rocks, I have thought over that completely, and I bought 4 pair of rusted socks which fit my bare feet neatly, and to keep out the cold I have bought a clog, and every day a cigar I will smoke, and all to follow my own dear true love of a kangaroo. So in this stanza, the duck explains that it has thought of this concerns already and has purchased 4 pair of socks, warm socks that fits its web feet well. The duck has also purchased a clog to stay warm and plans to smoke a cigar every day, also that it may ride along with its dear friend the kangaroo. Said the kangaroo, I am ready, all in the moonlight pale, but to balance me well, dear, it's steady and quite at the end of my tail. So away they went with a hop and a bound, and they hopped the whole world 3 times round. And who so happy, oh who, as the duck and the kangaroo. So in this stanza, the kangaroo announces that it's ready to leave that night. The kangaroo urged the duck to sit on the end of the kangaroo's tail to achieve the best balance possible. The duck and kangaroo take off hopping, and they travel around the world 3 times. There is no one as happy as a duck and the kangaroo.